Everybody, I'm Kirsty McKean. Welcome back to the Naio Nails channel. This is doing me adding, it keeps moving when I talk. We have a special guest today. She's so special because I love her and I know you all love her so much. And yes, it is the fabulous Fussy Faye. Round of applause, round of applause. This is Faye's nails as they are at the momento. So what we're gonna do is I'm gonna do a bit of prep work, get them all looking gorgeous, and we're going for a pink and purple theme. And we're going to do a gothic almond nail just for you. She's changing the shape.
Can you believe it?
Can you believe it? So we've got Faye's bits box. And these are the colours that she's chose today. We have got her files in here and everything. So these are Faye's files, so we keep them aside, obviously, so no contamination.
There aren't many colours, so we might add some more.
And this, these are all the colours that she's chosen.
They all look the same.
Adam. It's just a bit ridiculous.
Adam, don't say that. And I know they're not the same because they've all got different names.
And she's also added them as well.
Yeah.
And those. I'm confused.
I did soak off last night, so there isn't a massive amount of cuticle work that actually needs to be done, in all fairness. Rub that together for me, Faye. We'll do that before we start. So, yeah, gonna do this on all the nails. Obviously, watching that hypernickium, we don't want to go any lower. You don't want to start to file beneath the hypernickium. So, can you see that nice seal? Nice, lovely seal. Can you see it on your side? Beautiful. I just feel like your nails are really getting back to good condition after, you know, COVID. So, we're going to be sculpting today and we are going to be doing this amazing shape, which is one of my favourite, which is the the Russian almond.
You said gothic at the beginning.
Did I?
Yeah.
Oh, it's Russian. Similar. Right, so we're going to open the form at the back. We're going to lift the form a little bit. That's so it's going to be lifted up a little bit because we have opened the form at the back. This brings the form up. When I'm happy, I'm going to close the form. So if you look at the finger at the side, so keep your finger nice and straight for me, absolutely amazing. We're going to come straight out the side walls to here, to this point. To this point here, and then we're going to come up to the number four.
Oh, I can see the difference now between a gothic almond.
I'm going to dehydrate with the nail prep dehydrator. Then we're going to use the acid base primer. And then the first thing I'm going to do is pop down a clear, so we're going to use crystal clear acrylic. So this is going to be like a little base. We're going to make contact with the natural nail. I did, and it'll be on the video so you can watch in its full glory. So straight out of the side walls. Then as soon as we kind of hit this marker here, we're going to pull the product up at an angle. So I'm going to go from side to side, making sure that they are nice and equal. So I'm looking for this point here to be in line with this dot, yeah? Or this mark here. So I draw a straight line down there, and that's there. And we're going to check the other side. And we draw a straight line down there. Is it there? Have we got the same shape? Happy with that. I'm going to put a little bit of clear on the natural nail because we're going to use some strongly pigmented colours, and I want great adhesion, so the clear will provide that. Thank you. So we've got the nice clear base on, and then the colours that we're going to use are Ode to My Lover and Obsession. I love these colours. I am a big fan of pink and purple. Together, they are the perfect combination. What we're going to do is we're going to create a nice ombre, and I'm going to work at the tip first. Now, these are really pigmented, so you won't need to put it on thick. You know, you just want to use it kind of like a paint, and you can just colour that nail with a nice thin layer. It will add some strength, don't get me wrong, because it will. But when we put the clear over the top, when we come to cap, that's going to add the majority of the strength. So we're kind of sandwiching the colours between the clear, and that's not clear gel polish or anything like that, it's clear acrylic. So we're going to take this colour down, and then this is where we blend and overlay the colours, so they just sweep over and meet each other, and we want to create this ombre effect. So I'm just going to use that a little bit wet so we can feather that down. Now we're going to cap in clear. So like I said before, we're going to sandwich the colours between the layers of clear acrylic. So I'm going to start at the free edge first. And I'm starting at the free edge first because when the product makes contact with the heat from the finger, that will set up quite quickly. And I want to pinch this nail. So when I come to pinch it, if I did this area first, that would be set. And then this length wouldn't, because the heat from the finger will actually make the product set. So I'm going to pinch the nail, make it nice and slim.
Faye doesn't like chubby nails.
No, she'll be going crazy at me if she has a chubby nail. Right, let's take
what
this.
What was a horrible noise then?
Oh, it's nice.
I could snap the nail off. I was like, oh!
Right, I'm just going to hold that file there, man. So that's going to pull those sides nice and straight, so they don't like curl in.
Yeah, we don't want none of that, do we?
So now we're gonna file. I'm gonna go to my 120 grit file, and we're gonna do the side walls, getting them nice and straight. So you want to make sure that the side walls come in nice and straight with the finger. And then we're gonna file this the edge here, so we get a dramatic shape, so we get this gorgeous shape. So I'm just going to file underneath to file both edges at the same time.
And I got one up, one down.
Yep, so they're both the same height. Now I've done that, I'm going to use an electric file and just whiz over.
Whiz a was.
Whiz a wazza. The longer the nail, the bigger the apex needs to be. And if your name's Faye, you like a big apex.
Do we call it, it's now called the Fapex?
The Fapex, yeah.
The Fapex!
Definitely. I'm going to come very straight and flat at the sides. And then same on this side. One 80 grit file. We can refine the shape further. So just like I did with the electric file, I'm going to come quite nice and flat at the sides. So I'm not contouring yet.
So you didn't feel like, I didn't feel like you're putting that much pressure on that.
No, I don't need to.
Because is there a possibility you could then distort the shape of the nail?
Yeah. So I'm just going to buff now and get it nice and smooth. Right, I'm going to wipe over with a little bit of acetone just because I want to melt that top layer just a little bit, just so I get a really good clarity in the nail. Nice! So you can see you've got this nice apex at the back, you've got this gorgeous side wall scooping up, and you creep up out the apex and go straight, and it's straight out the side wall as well. Gorgeous shape, love it. So let's give it a bit of a top coat. So we're going to use the Urban Graffiti top coat. It's nice and shiny, it has a tack free surface. Into the lamp, please. This one, if you look at it, the distance between this point and the top of the nail is very similar to the distance between here and the top of the apex, yeah? Mm-hmm. So it's kind of like very similar all the way, and then it scoops up. With a Gothic Almond, it kind of drops down. Kind of like that. Gothic Almond's very similar to a modern almond, to be honest, not gonna lie. So this is the Vitamin E cuticle oil.
Vitamin E.
I know, love a bit of vitamin E.
So what? Where do you get vitamin free E apart from this cuticle oil?
Don't know. So there we are. That is the Russian almond in a nice ombre. Loving the colours. Love, 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 which we're obsession and ode to my lover. So yeah, that's a gorgeous Russian almond for the Fussy Fae with the fabulous nails.
Says loving it.
Everything I've used today will be listed below. Don't forget to check us out on Facebook and Instagram. And this is driving me a little bit nuts. Just saying.
Change it for the next video.
Yeah. I'll see you in the next video anyway. See what mask I've got on in the next video. Bye-bye. And with might need that.
There's an outtake.
SD card on mini.